Alright, thank you. So I'll start with a modest looking question. What's the biggest open problem in cryptography? There are a lot of answers. My answer will be personal, but it will be the same as the previous talk, which is, well, except for the provable part, but it's the security of AES. Well, as we know, it's used everywhere, every day, so it's a very important problem. I hope there are no arguments. And AES, actually, if you look about it, maybe it looks like messy and so on, but if you actually abstract it from a theoretical level, it's really beautiful. It's what is called a substitution permutation network, which essentially consists of, like, you know, structured round, in each round you do this addition, XOR, you know, the key essentially, with the key schedule, then you apply this parallel round of S boxes, and then you apply linear P, you know, P box, shift rows, shift columns, and so on, and then you iterate it. And the only non-linear piece is the S box, the only source of hardness, and there are a lot of, lots and lots of ciphers that follow this design, so it's really a popular design. So can we prove its security? Unfortunately, not unconditionally, unless P not equal to NP, and you know, there is like a sequence of a lot of beautiful works which kind of show security against restricted type of attacks. But we want to be ambitious, and the question is how can we do it? So traditionally in cryptography, we kind of idealize and abstract something of this kind, but here it's unclear how, because the picture was so beautiful, but the only source of hardness was the S-box, which is small by design, because we wanted to be efficient and so on. So there is no sound theory of iterating something small and simple for many rounds, and hopefully until this work. So I'm going to try to sell you this single small box cryptography, which is a mixture of proofs, which is something that I like, and hardness conjectures, which is something which is necessary unless we prove P not equal to NP. It consists of three steps. It could be applied to a lot of things. We apply it to SPNs and AES, but you can apply it to different things. The first step is this traditional hardest impressive reduced round proof. Then there is a hardness amplification step, which could be provable if you ignore the key schedule. And finally, there is this big kind of if, which is the new conjecture, which is a new kind of one-way function of this new branch of cryptography, which is what we call big to small conjecture. It explains existing ciphers and guides new cipher designs. There are non-specified big components, like in the previous modeling. And it's really, there are small differences, but it really, at the end, we will get real AES. And we get actually surprisingly something that we didn't anticipate. We get precise quantitative bounds with explicit dependence on the number of rounds. As Nathan said in the previous talk, we'll make AES great again. Now, from a theoretical point of view, namely, we'll give you exact bounds. So, let me tell you how it will look on AES. Using most aggressive framework setting of big to small conjecture, we'll get the following exactly exponential dependence on the number of rounds that AES will be 2 to the minus 8 R of S3 secure, which is a very respectable level of security already for 10 rounds, like 1 in 100 million, and you know, amazing level of security in 24 rounds, with random S boxes, but of course they're so small that you can actually hardwire it, so it's not a problem. With any linear P box whose matrix and inverse doesn't have zero, so it's not exactly yet, but close. You know, there are a lot of matrices satisfying this. And I believe it gives good guidance to practitioners to implement them. There are no unspecified components, there is quantitative round-dependent security, and there are, of course, proofs. So let's see how the previous kind of theoretical modeling started so that you can compare. First, in the previous like big box approach, you would kind of replace this little structure by a big permutation. Then you would, well, there is already a problem, you cannot call it SPN, so fine, we solve it by renaming it, we'll call it the alternating cipher. Then you prove security in this kind of big random permutation model, you get some bound, and now already one round is secure, we get the famous Steven Mansour cipher. And of course the question is it enough to bring theory to practice? And I believe the answer is no, and that's why we need this new theory that they call small box cryptography. So namely, it doesn't really address security of AES. So the problem is, like as you see with this approach, I replaced you know, the whole heart of the construction by a big yellow box, the kind of heart of the design. Of course, we cannot implement now this big thing with the analytic random permutation. So let me skip this thing and kind of tell essentially the picture what we get. So essentially, with this new approach, you look at SPN, you have this really beautiful exactly exponential security on number fronts, and I hope you will see it gives guidance to practitioners from that theorem, even if you don't know anything else. They can actually build a pretty respectable cipher, assuming our bounds are correct. With the previous thing, you look at this picture, there is one big box and two XORs. Well, and it's unclear what security it gets with the real world, and unclear how many rounds, and unclear how to implement this big permutation. So I guess if you ask people how to do it, I guess, you know, you will kind of get them, are you kidding me, you know, so. So essentially, now, of course, why is it better to follow a framework aside from the amazing results we get than AES is secure? So there are some answers. I'll try to give them in a minute. So first of all, we have a large provable component. We get quantitative bounds in a systematic way, so we implement these numbers that just come out from the proofs, and the numbers actually turn out to be quite bad. The big to small conjecture, I didn't tell you, is of course the big thing that you should try to break or, you know, validate. It doesn't have any components and so on. So it has a syntactically elegant description. Let's say I have 38 seconds. So the bigger picture is we need a theory of harnessing on small components. Conventional models assumptions fail. So this big to small conjecture is a new type of assumptions that help us to do stuff. And this is a new philosophy of design and analysis. Essentially, we want to do something in the small box world, the small box things, we don't know how to do it. We move to the big box world, we prove everything we can in that world. And then we go back, but now we're not empty-handed, we go back with quantitative bounds and stuff, and a lot of work remains, so you're not going to get what you want, because that's the thank you slide.